gentlemen. What's up, guys? Good evening. It's LeighAlity TV. It's the 420 episode. We're here. You already know who it is. It's your boy, Lee West. I'm Lee West.
Everybody here is high in some way or sense.
It's only the second floor.
It's like, I feel like the producer's high. We're everybody, the audience.
We started already, guys. We started, and you guys missed it.
As you can tell, we have cookies, chips, wine.
We're indulging in the flavors of snacks.
And we don't do this on the regular. It's a holiday, right?
It's a holiday. It's a holiday.
We do it on the regular.
I don't condone it, but I do condone it.
I don't do it on the regular, but they do.
What are you talking about? See, that I always said it though. I was like, I was never one of these like 420 guys. I was never like, dude, I never did that. Like, I don't care what time of day it is or what the calendar says. When I'm ready, I'm ready. You know what I mean?
Well, 420 is a more literal interpretation of it. I don't know. If you can't really know who what started it or whatever. There's always a ton of stories online. But apparently there was like this giant crop of marijuana that these boys were searching for, urban legend. And they would meet up every day after lacrosse or whatever in the 70s at 420 to go look for it. And they never actually found it, but 420 just kind of became the code, like not at 420.
Because they got out of high school football at 420.
Well, yeah, when all the athletics were over, they would gather and talk of this mystical.
You think it was lacrosse?
But they sound like lacrosse guys.
So they're white?
Most likely.
What does Bob Marley have to do with the day besides the fact that he smokes? Like, is it his birthday?
He's just like an infamous smoker, like Snoop.
Like, for some reason on Snapchat, there's Bob Marley's face all over the place, and I'm just like, are they just, like, remembering him because he used to smoke weed? Or is it just, like, that's kind of fucked up.
That's always relevant.
Like, he made really good music.
Beautiful, artistic music. And only known for his
And then just,
that.
Like, and the, all they know him for now is that they could put his face on yours via a Snapchat.
You know what
Snapchat
bugs me out is those face swaps. I can't even do one.
I can't look at them.
I can't. It's like, I'm going to report that shit for profanity.
I'll lose my shit.
No, I don't report shit. I ain't no snitch.
Yeah, you see people like swapping their face with like inanimate objects now. Like, you know, with like statues or like picture frames and it's like
bags.
Dogs, I've seen dogs, but they're adamant objects. They're not inadamant. They're adamant.
Unless it's a taxidermed dog. If you got a taxidermed, then you could.
I work next to a taxidermy.
Do you really?
Actually, somebody came into my job today, through the back garage bay door, and he's just like, excuse me, did you see a boxer around? I'm like, a boxer? Like a little dog. There's a dog just running around it. I'm trying to find it. He ran over by the taxidermy. I'm like, that's not the place where the dog should go.
This was today?
This was today, swear to God.
That guy was high on PCP.
I didn't even think. It was today. Like, he just walked out.
That dog was not there.
I'm making hoses, and he's just
making
like,
hoes.
Have you seen a boxer? Like, he didn't even say dog. Have you seen a boxer? I'm like, are they just people fighting?
Just duking it out.
Just duking it out in the back.
Like, in the street. Yeah, you got Lady Carnage going up against Vinny the Beast.
Oh, yeah.
Homeless people fights?
No. They were fighters that we had on the show.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Where was I for that episode?
You were here for Vinny the Beast or no?
Sure was not.
Script Keeper and Tony Slippers.
We've had two UFC fighters on the show.
Well, three,
really?
Actually.
Yeah, three, yeah.
Two, because Blood Axe and Lady Carnage came in the same
That's true.
Show. And then, you know, Vinny the Beast came with Script and Slippers.
It's just so mellow here. Like, it's so nice. So, like, you know, they got chips, they got cookies. We had our guest.
Truffles?
You want to talk about our guest that might not come on that, like, supplied us with cookies?
Yeah, we had one of our guests. They had a possible medical emergency, so they dipped out quick.
But we got plans. We got tricks up our sleeves.
We got an incredible treat for you guys this evening. We got Devin G in the building with us this evening.
They gave us a treat, too.
You going to try one?
We don't know if these are wheat cookies, Brian.
I don't know either.
I don't care.
They look good, though.
They might be.
LA the producer. No, he's the engineer, right? You're the engineer?
Yep.
I think they are.
I'm the producer. He's the engineer.
They are.
Are they really?
Yeah. No way.
Smell it.
I taste it.
I taste it too.
Wow.
I can go smell it.
Our food.
This is great.
This is awesome!
Great. This is a complete surprise to those at home. I don't really smoke that much.
So wait. Well, hold up.
They're weed cookies?
Yeah.
No, they're definitely
weed cookies. Why is that other kid going to the hospital, though?
Probably tasted weed cookies.
Hang on.
Oh, wait a minute. We're eating the same cookies the dude ate when he was in the hospital.
I took a shit. I don't know.
He might be a separate thing.
How do you know?
Thing. I didn't really smoke anything, and I taste it. I'm eating the whole thing. I don't fucking care. It's a good cookie.
We're going to see what's going to happen here.
It's a tasty cookie. So you remember the time the last time I had weed cookies was at your Project Nightline event. what was it called?
Oh, my God.
So tell America. Vetstock. All right. So I'm at Vetstock, right? All day I'm at Vetstock. Drinking, partying, having a great time. I took a break. It was summer. It was hot. I had to go take a break. So I go. I sit in the car. I put the AC on. I just chill out for a couple minutes. And just vegging out for a minute. I got like second wind. I got to pee. And I'm going back to the party, right? So I stand next to the car. I pee next to a tree.
Oh, we're alive.
All of a sudden, you hear this door swing right open. Well, bam! Cookies work!
Cookies? I'm sorry. Your story is fucking boring. Your story is fucking boring.
Story sucks.
You're boring everybody right now.
Well,
how fast do these kick in?
No, there's people over here. They want. Oh, you're the next show. You're not
even.
Yeah,
the next. Kenny, go sit down. What are you doing?
I was waving down Devin. I thought those were guests.
Oh.
And I was like, yo, Devin, could you just have them come over here? I feel like they thought they were going to interrupt the show. Oh. So I'm almost over here like, hey, Devin, could you go? And we're on live TV. And then I remember. I said, fuck it, I already fucked up the show. Let me just go get them over
just
here.
Just keep it going.
And they're the next show. They're not even our guests. Our guests are still MIA.
You guys can come chill with us.
If you guys can come chill. They're preparing, man.
They got a...
They're scared of us. Look at you. Like,
do you look like an approachable person? Yes, I have a very loving smile.
They got to smoke L's.
Oh my God. Jesus Christ. This scared the shit out of me. And you weren't even looking at me.
Boogity.
Oh man, this is fun.
You guys are idiots.
Yeah, we're idiots.
I'll be an idiot, but I don't want you to shy away from saying that you're an idiot too. That's really unfair.
Oh no, we're all. If you call. You have to.
Think you are who you associate with.
I say you gotta hang with like minded people.
Yeah, I can't believe I'm hanging out with you fucks.
So. In light of 420, we're having such a great time today. Let's see, what time is it?
It's only been 10 minutes.
So, I really thought that 420 thing was like a totally different. I thought it was like a LAPD, like police. Like we got a breaker 420 on the spot.
I didn't research this.
Youngsters.
Yeah, when I looked up the stuff today, I didn't see anything about that. No.
Yeah, I was just misled by. Retards, it's all good.
I know it's Hitler's birthday. Happy birthday to Hitler.
Yeah. Right? I saw a meme today crack me up, and it said, a birthday message to Hitler, right? You're dead, and the Jews run the world.
That's fucking hysterical.
I mean, not as much as Hitler died.
When was the last time you smoked?
I've taken puffs here and there, but I've never...
The last time you were done.
Last time I got fucking blitted. It had been like maybe like...
So it's like 2006 because you said blitted.
If he still says blitted...
2006, okay.
Yeah, I guess. I guess like...
You can laugh out loud, that's right.
Maybe like 2 years ago or something like that.
Really?
It was the last time like I like finished a blunt with people in a group or like, you know, did like a steamroller or anything like that.
Steamroller. That was like...
Remember when it was like just getting dumb highly, like just dumb? Now we just do it to get normal.
And it's like, all right, let me level my head out and think about some stuff.
I'm just very stressed out right now. I need to laugh and just like get through all the filters. But like dumb high, like this is one of the first times I ever get high, I laughed on the ground, face red, because of the thought of what if you got married and you never lived with your spouse before and she still wet the bed. That'd be horrific.
Are you nine? Yeah. Like, what?
Like, what if you just got married and your spouse just still wet the bed? You wake up one night covered in her. You love her. So, I mean, it couldn't be that big of a deal, but...
Well, I mean, like, you know, I'm not going to go there. I mean, like, squirt smells like pee sometimes.
Wait, so you thought about this, or did this happen in your life?
I was 14.
You were 14? So you were 14 when your first time was getting high, and you thought about people wetting the bed?
Yeah.
That's what goes through your head?
It would have been awful.
It would have been. It would be awful. It would be. I'm sure it would be.
So you're already thinking, at 14, you're thinking about marriage, sleeping in the same bed, and urinating on each other.
Weird guy. I don't know.
I'll never forget one time I was so high that, like, I was at a friend's house, and I used to go to this friend's house just to smoke, and, like, they lived right around the corner from my job, so, like, if I had a bad day, I'd just go there and, like, throw them a little bit of cash and just, like, smoke out of their bong, and then their friend came over, and they had a box of donuts, Dunkin' Donuts, and then an entire 12 thing, and they put it on the bed, and they went into the other room. And, like, within 5 minutes, I ate all 12 donuts. All 12 donuts. And they came back, like, you didn't even leave one donut? And I just looked at them and laughed. I didn't even say anything. And he's like, it's not fucking funny. I bought an entire box. And I just looked up and I laughed. I had no other reaction besides laughing. Oh, God, that was funny.
Now you have to eat, like, edibles to get that high.
I really like the chocolate balls.
I could probably, like, smoke a blunt and be, like, fucking, like, in a whole new world.
A whole like, new like dropping ass.
You have now referenced Aladdin 2 days in a row.
I like Disney movies. Is that weird? You Disney think about movie. Urinating on...
This can't be boring.
I like animated feature films.
Fair enough. Film, though.
Film. Oh, I like all of Disney.
We were on the Gugut show last night. That's what we're talking about.
Oh, yeah,
about.
We were on the Gugut show.
Yeah, shout out to the Guguts.
Mr. Benny over there.
Benny Mazzuti. Nicole.
And the Asian girl.
Genie Powers.
How can you not reference Aladdin when her name was Genie Powers? I'm just like, well, you
I know. And I asked her, like,
and Bewitched.
You got a rub the lamp a genie or some shit. I don't know. It got weird.
Got weird. Yeah, well, nobody was really.
I said she looked Asian because she worked for Honda.
She looked Asian because her eyes were squinty.
That was the best part. Is he goes, you look, you got Asian in you because you said Honda before.
Because he says something about Honda.
She's got slanted eyes. She's blatantly Asian. I think he said her dress too. Like your dress is Asian.
It looked like
it was a white sundress. What the fuck? It didn't look Asian.
It looked Asian. It was very oriental.
If she had, like, one of those fans in her hair, or chopsticks going through her buns, that would have been, like...
That would have sold a few.
Kabuki makeup.
All right. So, let's go to the 420 video. And then we'll come back and we'll have Devin G with us over here.
Devin G.
So, ladies and gentlemen, there's a little something in YouTube bullshit I found. It was pretty funny, pretty 420 appropriate, and it's animated, seeing as we all love animated such.
I do.
So much. Well, you know, I watch Family Guy. So check this out.
Are you smoking?
Just a little holy tobacco. Nothing wrong with that, no. Would you care for a drag?
Oh, I don't mind if I do.
As more states pass medical marijuana laws, pot is starting to seem like it's pretty much legal. But when I tried to buy some at 7-Eleven, they looked at me like I was crazy. So I stole this from my son. Which reminds me, Andrew, you're grounded.
God damn it!
Drug number one, weed.
Oh no, we're out of weed.
He's a giant marijuana joint who wears a cowboy hat.
I know you're high.
Mom, that one is smoking.
It's fine, honey. If a priest is doing it, it must be okay with God.
That's why we're here, so that you can get high?
You wanted a half cube of Panthropus and an eighth of napalm.
Yes!
What are we gonna do, Sam?
Well, we could start voting in midterm elections.
That's kind of a pain, and you know it. But...
It's always Leviticus 420 somewhere.
Well, then hand it over. I want some.
Hey, what's happening, people? If you haven't noticed, marijuana is legal in, whatever
American state I live in. It's made a ton of cash for the government and helped my numerous medical conditions.
Borts, your eyes are red once again.
Oh, we were splitting the atom again in science class, and I'm allergic to split atoms, remember?
Yar, can I give ye a ride?
Are you kidding me? Yes!
Are you the zigzag rolling paper guy? I thought he was French.
Mayhaps the bro thinks I resemble a pirate, so that be the voice I have.
You smoke way too much weed.
Thanks for the heads up, Teddy. Take as much coke as you want, I say.
Ramirez, I'm a cop. I don't do coke.
Why don't you just smoke marijuana like a normal person? Why?
Honey, remember thou shalt not bogart the sacrament.
Well, that was weird.
What was weird?
I don't remember.
I think I'm tripping out, man. The sky is purple, man.
Everyone knows you're high.
Oh, thy will be done, that's good sh**.
I think I feel Jesus moving through me.
All right, no, you've got enough of the Jesus in you.
I am quite stoned.
But I don't appreciate you being high while you're working. Is it okay for a bartender to be drunk? Or a surgeon to be high on Oxycontin? I mean, whatever happened to the American work ethic?
Every man was born with an inalienable right to freedom, and I'm willing to fight for it.
Oh, you're so hot when you're self-righteous and hypocritical.
Wait a minute, you've still got me. Holy smoke.
Does Jesus make you hungry?
Now when did this car start flying?
Come on, come on.
And this is why I hang out with you.
I'm sorry, I totally forgot what's going on. Are we still doing the news?
You're doing it now.
You're doing it now. Can we get a pizza?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, you enjoyed that? I was cracking up when I watched it earlier today. To be honest, I didn't really pay attention much this go around, but I was setting up for Devin Giannini. I did it. Ladies and gentlemen, we got a couple minutes. He's gonna do a little something for us. He's got a little set for us right here on the green wall for the 420 status of the actually the wall's always green. And it's a green screen wall. Ladies and gentlemen, clap at your computer, studio audience, make some noise. We got Devin Giannini.
Right here. Yeah.
Devin, you're the man. Okay, you gonna tear it down for us? You got a couple jokes about?
Yeah, a couple jokes.
This guy got some jokes. What do you think you are? Some kind of comedian or something?
Something like that.
So, yeah. All right, my brother. Do you think? We'll see you over on the couch.
All right. Hello. Yeah. I'm not really that smart of a guy. I'm actually kind of the dumb guy in my group of friends. Which really says something, because we met in special ed. Yeah. When the leader of your group is the kid with the Burger King hat and no pants, I think it's time for a re-election. They tricked me into special ed. They made it sound so cool. I walked in. I was right in front of the classroom, and the principal said, "You know, hey, Devin, time to go in. This is your time to shine. Go. Go along to special ed." I told him I'm not going in there. I'm not falling for this one. This ain't gonna be me. I'm not going in that classroom. He said, "You're right, Devin. You're too smart for me." And then he reached into his pocket and he pulled out a Twinkie and threw it in the classroom. So I walked after it. I had to investigate. I was poor and fat back then. The way I saw it, that was lunch/dinner. Yeah. And it kind of impressed me, though, Yeah, because when I walked in the classroom, this is what hooked me. I saw a bunch of kids painting the walls, but they were painting the walls with banana peels. Yeah. Now I kind of realize that they were a little slow, but back then I just thought they knew high art. Yeah. I do love hanging out with my friends, though. I love hanging out with my brother. I think he's a good friend. My brother James. Yeah, we like to bond together. We like to take the train to the city sometimes. Yeah, the one thing we like to do, especially when we take the train to the city, hide in the bathroom the entire time because we don't like paying for things. And we always think we're badass when we're doing it. Like, we're always looking at each other like, yeah, man, we're beating the trains. But then we get to our last stop, and all the other passengers see us leave the bathroom together. Yeah, to us, the conversation looks like we're saying, yeah, man, we're beating the trains. To them, it just looks like we're saying, yeah, man, we just fucked on a train. We did it the entire time. No one knocked once. Nah, I do like hanging with family, though. Yeah, family's important. Speaking of 420, one time my dad actually tried to smoke weed with me. Yeah, it's weird smoking weed with your parents. You don't want to do it. I said no to it because it was going to be super awkward. I mean, what do you say when you smoke weed with your dad? Like, man, I hope you don't catch me. I would be in so much trouble. I do like to go on trips and stuff like that. I like going trips with my parents. I like to go trips with my mom. We only went on one trip together. We went to Canada when I was 16, turned 17. Yeah, but the shitty thing was I got sick. Yeah, I got the flu. I got cold. My nose is running. So to cheer me up for my birthday, my mom decided to take me to the restaurant down the street. But a guy started following us. And he started staring at my mom's purse. Yeah. And I think any other day of the week, you're your mom's baby. You know? She always looks at you like the baby. She always looks at you you're a little baby. Oh, look at the baby boy. Oh, you're such a baby. You're my baby. I'm like, I'm 18. Like, no, you're my 18 baby. Yeah. But then when someone's about to steal her Gucci bag, it's like, it's man time, motherfucker. You're not a fucking baby. Yeah, so I had to come up with a plan, and I came up with a good one. I was going to flip the script on the mugger. So what I did was, when he got close enough, I turned around, I stabbed him, and I stole my mother's purse. He was surprised. Turns out Canada's actually pretty fun after that. Canada's actually pretty fun when you have money. I don't know how mom's doing, but I'm sure she's speaking French right now. Thank you, guys. I'm Devin Giannini. Good night.
Devin G, man.
Thanks, man. That was a crush. Thanks.
Awesome. And so did you, like, you know, talk to Cam and tell him who you are, where you're from, too?
I'm Devin Giannini, D-E-V-I-N-G-I-A-N-N-I-N-I. From Deer Park, New York.
Deer Park
represent. I was going to be that asshole. Deer Park represent, what's up?
So Deer Park's like a really white town too, right?
They're not very white. I mean,
they're
white, but like they're white.
It used to be so pure, but then it's rich. Yeah. It's driven snow, and then they moved.
Sunshine,
in.
You want the other one? You don't like that one?
But that was pretty interesting. Your entire set. Were you really in these special ed classes?
Yeah.
Yeah. I was in special ed also.
For sure. Yeah, I was in special ed.
That's wild.
I was in it until 10th grade, and then they took me out because they're like, oh, he's not eating with a spoon anymore. He's eating with a spork. He's doing pretty good.
It's real ingenuity.
Yeah. That's how they let you know. Like, all right, he's not reading too good, but he's eating with a spork now, so things are going pretty good. One day, he'll stop using the safety scissors. Let's pace it, you know?
I wouldn't judge you if you use the safety scissors.
You didn't want that one?
They do. They are helpful.
Well, I mean, I don't really, you could still cut shit you know, I guess they're not as stabby, right?
It's, yeah, the stabby. You could figure out a way.
Do you ever use the scissors that are like, they go like in the hand?
Yeah, what's
and
with
you're
that?
Like, wow, this is so cool.
Because it's cutting straight still, you know, but it's like squiggly.
It's all squiggly.
What is that for, doilies and stuff?
Yeah, I think so. Mm. Did you ever use these?
They didn't let us have a lot of sharp things.
No sharp things.
Because, well, there was kids. There wasn't just kids who were mentally challenged in the room. There was, like, kids, like, well, I guess kind of mentally challenged, but they were, like...
Was it resource room? Was
bipolar. There was bipolar kids in the room. Like, one time... shit. Do you know when High School Musical came out?
Right?
Yeah. Well, everyone in my class was really excited about High School Musical. Like, this was third grade. It just came out. We were all, like, really excited, and now it's kind of gay, but, like, back then, it was awesome. Everyone wanted to be those guys, and I was the one with the best voice in class, you know, whatever.
Yeah!
Not much to brag, but, you know, whatever. I was the Troy of the group. If you know High School Musical, I was Troy. So
Never seen it. We have sex with females.
I've never seen the movie. I've had sex with females too. Right?
I've never seen it either, but I imagine it's the most well.
It cost like $100, but like I was like female.
What, having sex with females? Because you're spending too much on dinner, bro. 2 for $20.
Wait, he gets dinner.
I got dessert, dude. I got dessert.
Cause you ate that cake.
You know what?
so I feel.
What's up?
I feel that I am slightly behind with some stuff too, that I was developmentally growing up, like ever since the get-go, and I think I routed it all down to my mother.
Always comes back to the parents.
Always comes back to the parents, cause if you think about it, when I first went to reach for a pen. Right, to write, to learn how to write, I went to reach with my left hand. And my mother's like, no, screw that, you're going to be a righty. And she forced me to put the pen in my right hand.
Because the Christians used to believe that was evil.
Yeah, and yeah. I think she thought I was like an evil baby or some shit.
You are an evil baby.
So I was forced to write with my right hand. And now when I write everything backwards. I write my letters upside down and shit.
Makes sense.
It's weird, and I feel like everything is a little bit off. That I was supposed to be lefty, and I'm never that good at
much. We're supposed to relay the message to the other side now. Right. And I was like, wait, I'm fucking...
This is heartbreaking, man.
I know.
Tonight I want you to go home. I want you to write a nice haiku with your left hand. Then I want you to jack off with your left hand. I want you to feel what you were meant to be.
We went with the stranger last week. We talked about the...
I mean, that's, you know...
How many times have you ever tried the other hand?
Only when I broke my arm, and it was terrible.
I might have tried...
It was terrible.
A few times.
You really didn't know me.
I do overhand righty. I do the western.
Overhand righty.
Overhand righty.
Dear Lord.
Wait,
always.
Hold on. Wait, what?
Not for special occasions.
Are you struggling right now?
No. That's how I go about it. Are we talking about it? Similar technique.
Overhand righty.
Overhand. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the best way. Oh wait, it's like the western is the stranger. We're talking about masturbating now, America.
Yeah. Hi, Mom. I get the.
She is watching, isn't she?
She's watching it. She's showing it to my dad right now.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Giannotti.
I think my aunt Angie's watching this right now.
It's pretty wild hey, that Ange. we have options to jerk off.
Yeah.
Like, honestly, I just go the old fashioned through tried and true all the time. That's what I feel like female masturbation.
Try overhand. Trust me, you're not.
I've done it. Don't get me wrong. I've just been bored, so I'll just give it a whirl.
Have you ever heard the myth that you sit on your hand? And then you use it, and like it's like someone else is there.
Yeah, the shit you make your hands.
I don't got that kind of time.
I've never tried that.
Yeah, no.
Like I'm not the guy who would try that.
Yeah, I'm not with that. Yeah.
Oh, but actually, cool. I totally went off on the tangent with the story. The there was this really tall, like 6'2", wagon in the class. His name was Jack, and he was fucking huge.
Was he jacked? Was Jack jacked?
Jack was jacked. He was like 10. But he looked like 19, and he was like, he was taller than all of us. And when people said like I was the best singer in class, and we were like doing songs and stuff, he was like, no, I'm the best singer. No, I'm the best singer. And then one day they're like, no, you're not. And then he took the chair and tried to come at me with it. And he
you guys didn't have a sing off. He was gonna hit you with a chair.
I told him, you're the best singer. You're the Troy of the group with the name Troy. It kind of makes sense.
Yeah, like the Achilles, he was invincible.
He was the Achilles. I think he got in trouble like a few times. Like he tried to like he had a teacher. There was a few kids that...
Disrespectful.
Yeah, there was a few kids who were trying to stab a teacher once. So.
This is hardcore shit. What school district is this?
I mean, it's the classroom. Jeff Hart,
bro.
Dear Lord.
Well, shit, he didn't use, like stabby stuff to stab them.
But you don't expect normal kids to do this.
I mean, William Floyd got a heroin center, but I mean...
Wait, the heroin center?
Yeah, well, they call it a wellness center. But...
Did you hear that?
Is that what wellness centers are?
The bus driver in North Massapequa got arrested for selling heroin to kids.
Well, you know, being a bus driver is probably a pretty good racket.
That's true.
Yeah,
everybody rides a bus does drugs.
Everybody that rides a bus? Yeah, but it's not like a bus driver to adults. It was a bus driver to kids.
Did he sell heroin? How old are these kids on the bus?
I at least hope middle school.
You just need to shoot that guy right in the head.
It to the kids.
What are you gonna do with that?
No. He was just a heroin selling bus driver.
Oh, I guess that's nice.
We skipped a bunch.
If
of
he didn't sell
the
to the kids on the bus.
So we do have an unfortunate RIP. We gotta talk about. We got Kenny's friend's mom passed away recently.
This is terrible. They're setting it up like this.
Kenny had a joke where he hangs out with the brother from Everybody Loves Raymond. But do the voice.
I haven't done it so long. I've gone through puberty. It's
all right. Anyway, Kenny does the voice great.
Right.
And unfortunately, the grandma from Grandma's Boy, the mother from Everybody Loves Raymond, she had passed away.
We knew Doris personally. Many fundraisers with excellent shrimp cocktail. just a real great hostess, genuine person.
Honestly, man, I really loved this woman.
She's hilarious.
Every time I watch Raymond, like wholeheartedly, I laughed hysterical because of this lady.
She's the one that tears it up.
I thought Everybody Loves Raymond was okay. I loved her. I just loved the movie Grandma's Boy when it came out. I watched it with my brothers like 5 times. Grandma's Boy is like the funniest movie, and she has some great laugh lines. Okay. What the fuck's happening?
It's chaos.
To the last cushion.
Alright, I'm here. Alright. But no, Grandma's Boy was when she's like, the captain's so cool on Captain Crunch. He's eating the syrup. The captain's so cool. I wish he'd just pop off the box and come party with us. And the dude's like, I'm not even high enough to get that one. She's like, you know what? No Captain Crunch for you. Boom! And just yanked that shit.
She hands it to the biker.
Yeah.
It's like, sucks to be you, nerd.
And that was great. Ever since then, I always put weed in my tea.
That was such a great movie.
No, it was.
That didn't even go in the theater.
It was in the theater.
Like a limited release. Yeah.
3 days, they said. That's what Nick Swanson says. Yeah. For like 3 days, it was out, and then they took it back.
And I saw something that's 10 years old, right? That movie now.
Yeah,
is it?
Yeah, it's gotta be that old.
I guess.
All right, so while we're here, let's address who else we got with us. Good morning. Who are you, Chad? Listen to me over here. Yeah, I'm talking to you. Who are you with over there? You got DJ Bone, Chad, and
C4. We got
Adriana. Alright, seeing as you guys came in like a half hour late, I don't have enough time to perform.
That's cool with me.
Devin Gianni took your spot, so if you want,
wheat cookies.
Beat him up. Oh my god.
Yeah, I know. I found that out after a few bites.
Yeah. Let's talk about some bullshit tonight, man.
So,
I want these guys to stay too. I didn't get to hear what they were
saying. No, he's chilling. We're all chilling right now. But I just so we know who you are and everything. We got enough room.
Let's bring him on.
You want to leave Devin up or put him on the sit? You want to squish?
Yeah, I'm not ready.
You want me to get
up? Let's see what we got. Let's get these guys on over here. You got what's up, my brother?
Good to see you, bro.
All right, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, man.
Bone, you coming?
Good.
Come on, you guys can squish.
I'm excited, man. It's nice to meet you. All right, we're going to have to scoot over a little bit.
Alright, what's up, guys?
What's up?
Look at the
camera. Where's the camera at?
Right there. Look at the camera. Tell the people who you are waiting for and what do you do.
Get
your feet off the couch.
I can't. Other than that, I look like a little bitch. With my legs all squeezed together.
No, but go ahead. Tom.
Judgment free zone, bro.
What are we doing here? What am I doing?
We're just trying to make
that's white people shit. White people do that.
I'm going to do this joint right here.
There you go. That's the one.
I like this.
So go ahead. Tell the people who you are.
I'm good. I'm Good Morning. I go by the name of Good Morning. This is my engineer, a fucking young virtuoso. This nigga's amazing at engineering and making beats and just being dope.
Awesome. What is his name?
C4 Boom.
C4 Boom, because that's what C4 does. It booms.
Wow. What a guy I would never would have thought. Yeah. You're very good at this, Lee.
Did you guys vote yesterday?
Nah,
I didn't take part.
Yeah, I didn't vote either. You know why? Because voting doesn't matter. Yeah.
But it's our right to not matter.
Well, hey, you know, I laugh and everybody's like, I can't believe this, I can't believe that. How do you not believe it? Everybody knows this shit was rigged from day one, you know?
They already have the winner.
It's Hillary. Hillary's going to be the president.
Everyone knew it was going to come down to Trump and Hillary the whole time.
Right, and it's not going to be Trump.
Hillary won by a landslide. It was crazy.
I think it's going to be Trump.
That's if people actually voted. Like, if the votes actually count. They don't. Sorry, I went political on you.
I wanted Bernie to win, though, because he had that interview with Killer Mike, and I was messing with him heavy after that.
Yeah?
Yeah. Okay. Something like that. But, yeah.
I don't vote. I can't vote. But
I can't vote either.
I was upset at myself. I went to vote. And I looked up my status, and I realized I didn't enroll in a political party. And I knew I had to be in a political party, but like I found out that you had to be enrolled since November, I believe, in order to vote.
I have any kind of party
in your primary.
You want to call it political?
I know. Instead of not enrolled in a party. Fuck that.
I like having parties.
He has parties all the time at the Wild West Estates.
Wild West Estates party popped off last Saturday. It was pretty dope.
I mean, speaking of parties, I'm having an individual party right now. It's 420.
Word.
420. And they made us these wonderful cookies, which we found out were a surprise treat.
We had no idea.
I didn't think they were leading them, man. That's fucking so cool.
Can I say who we can thank for that, or is that illegal?
Yeah, it is illegal, bro. But it's up to you if you want to throw them out there.
Courtesy
like
of High Art Creative. I'm just going to say that.
High Art.
I took a bite. You can see my...
And the excellent cookies. You know what I hate about weed cookies and stuff is like they don't normally taste good. Mm-hmm. You know, and he's like, excellent cookies. And that was like that peanut butter cookie I had by your place. It was like,
secretly drugging people since 1988.
How long does the cookie normally take before like you feel like...
Well, I mean, if you take a look at our studio audience member, I looked over, half the plate was gone. I'm like, give me that plate.
Word though, like anyway, so.
But so you guys got a project coming up?
No, we got a project out already.
All right, coming out. I mean, I'm sorry.
Nah, it's already out. It dropped last Friday. It's called Foreplay. It's doing really well. Everybody loves it. Which, you know, we worked really hard on it last year. Last year was crazy because I came home from work one night on some bullshit, and I came to his crib with like some crazy ass gold tie on, and I was like, yo. We gotta make it. Like, I'm giving this one more year of like straight dedication, and we're gonna pop off, and I just need you to believe me. And he was like, "Fuck it, I'm with it," you know, because Bone had introduced me to C4.
Word.
And we originally started doing work out of my home studio. And he was engineering some records and it was going good, but he has like a way better studio than I do. Like, this dude's studio is like way advanced, and
you gotta stay up to date with the equipment.
Yeah, and he knows all the all the like, just everything that you would need to know, all the little nuances and all the cool little tricks that you can do with vocals, and as far as like mixing and blending. Can I get one of those?
That shit's so important.
Yeah.
That shit's so important. That'll take your track to the next level.
Yeah, you know, and basically off of that, I use that to kind of get around a little bit. Some of the records that I completed at his studio, I use that to get around and like, you know, get some other people that I was interested in to work with me, like Mike West. Shout out to Mike West.
Is that my cousin?
Yeah.
Yeah, I might be related.
Yeah, yeah, right.
Oh, my bad. I was right. Ancestry.com.
Word. Nah, but Mike West is insane, too. So, once he heard, you know, the four records that I came to him with, I was like, yo, listen, you know, I'm working with C4, but I'm really looking for your expertise on this, too. Like, I really want you to, you know, work with me going forward in the future. And so he heard those records, but I was like, yo, I don't want nothing for free though. Like, I don't want nothing for free. I'm just bringing you these records right here. I want to take these records to the next level. And he was like, all right, cool. Give me a little while to hear them and, you know, and I'll get back to you. So like on the random one night, he hit me up and he was like, he was like, son, I don't get shit like this in my studio. Just come over here, man. Just come over and we're just going to do some work. And I was like, yo, that's super peace. That's super love right there. Cause Mike doesn't fuck around, you know what I mean? Can I curse?
Yeah.
All right, cool.
This Mike doesn't fuck around. Parental advisory in the corner over there.
Yeah.
We're ready.
That's what's up. Because I'll be cursing.
Fuck that.
Yeah. Don't listen.
The fuck you saying? You can't fucking curse on the fucking show, bro? Yeah,
right. After we fucking...
I don't use that many
fucking
fucks.
Virgin ears.
I don't do that. I use fuck very... No, that's cool.
Very loosely.
I don't say...
I'm trying to be cool with it.
It's like certain words I just don't use, you know? Quite
adamant. So after that we get to working, and after that I really started, I'm not gonna get into exactly what our arrangement was, but I will say that messing with him, I ended up getting a lot of music over to like artists like Vado, Tory Lanez,
awesome.
French Montana, you know, Fab too, you know, just really, you know, because I'm also a writer, you know what I mean? So right. like. You know, I don't have a problem selling music, you know, selling ideas that don't work, that, you know, don't work for my particular brand. So that's what we were doing. And I made a lot of great contacts over the year. And eventually I ran into DJ Radio, who works at Shape 45 with DJ K Slay. Shout out to Radio.
K Slay!
You know what I mean? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Who then introduced us to, who got us the distribution deal with Foundation Media. Shout out to Foundation Media.
Foundation? No, over there. You're looking at the screen.
Okay.
Yeah,
Foundation
I know.
Media. Thanks for telling me that 30 minutes
your
into
your lady friend. Your lady
nah, it was
friend
a good
right
gimmick,
there.
Man. It looked like you were like looking off in the
I was looking too.
You were looking and you were following my shit.
All right, cool. Just as long as that's what it is.
Now, like, I tried I was looking on Bones' page. I saw you did a little something over the summer 16. I had a little trouble finding a link for that.
It was Pop Style.
But I had a little trouble finding the music in general. But so you mentioned name like Tory Lanez. So does that make you like an R&B dude, or like what is your vibe?
My vibe is versatile. You know what I mean?
Okay.
I wouldn't say that I'm an R&B dude. I would just say that
Tory Lanez.
Ain't
always,
R&B dude.
He always comes
no,
up on R&B. Joe Budden's always talking about R&B dudes. He's always talking about Tory Lanez. So I want to know what your music's like. I'm feeling your gimmick. I'm feeling your vibe. Bone, I know, has got an eye for talent, so I know you got to be doing something good.
Yeah, I mean,
you met him
last week. I think C4. I want to have C4 answer that, because I don't want to answer it for myself. I just want to have C4 take that over and let him tell you what it is. Because
sorry, Ken.
I don't want to talk about it.
I mean, he's definitely not an R&B dude. All
right.
but he definitely will dabble in. Some harmonizing every now and then.
Okay.
All right.
But yeah, he's a rapper. He's a lyricist.
I mean, I know you how long now? Probably maybe like 5 years
yeah,
at least.
The better part of 5 years.
Yeah.
And have you done any? You've done a few of my events, right? You came to the theater, and you did. Yeah, we had a good time, man.
We had a good time, but I think that the music has taken a crazy turn since then for the better. It's way more focused now, and a lot more direct, especially with this project right here. It's called Foreplay, and we just had a good time making it. This is like mad music though, like it's a year's worth of music.
46.
But and so basically the plan is to release one every quarter. We were kind of late this quarter, so the next one is gonna come in July. But I mean, right now I have enough music to.
All
right.
So do you have one song like right now we can drop for the people?
Yeah,
we can draw
yeah.
it on your phone.
Yeah,
who's
yeah.
got the phone? You got the phone?
Is there
yeah,
a way
go,
to
go go step over there and let me get DJ Bone over here while you go ahead
which
and step
one?
Up over
yeah.
there.
Pick one. Okay.
Whatever one you want. We'll drop one in there. Track.
I mean,
and,
yeah.
What song?
Leroy.
Pick whatever one you want.
Now, Bone, you come over here. Let him put the song on.
No, I don't want to sing.
Come on,
yeah.
come on.
No. Let him.
You just gotta keep moving. You gotta keep moving. There you go.
I don't got my invisible
exit
people shades.
Alright, Bone doesn't want to come play with us.
You know
he's not wearing his invisible people shades.
I need the invisible people shades.
That's
right.
Sunglasses.
It's going to be like Big Daddy.
It is Big Daddy. It's invisible people sunglasses.
There we go. I don't see nobody right now.
Look at this.
Awesome. What's up, everybody?
DJ Bone.
DJ Bone.
What it do?
What's good,
who's
what's
there?
Good?
What is this?
What's up, man? DJ Bob.
Oh, hello, DJ.
I'm getting dabs from an invisible person. Like my son.
What's up, everybody? Yo, don't look at the shoes.
I got the same ones.
I got the same ones too. I got the same ones.
Don't wear those shoes. The camera
don't
even
let me get into the story about those shoes.
Yeah, don't get into the story.
Let's get to the music, man.
Tell about the story, boy. Tell about the story.
Hang on. What we do here on the show is we peel the person out of the entertainer. We get to know the person behind. We all go on stage. We all shine in the light. We all got families. We all got jobs. We all got, you know, kids, nephews, nieces. This, that, whatever we do. Tell me about the shoes.
Tell me about the shoes.
Yo, listen. All I'm gonna say about the shoes before we get into the music is that it's my fault, okay? That's all I'm gonna say. You can blame me, all right?
So I'm gonna rock the shoes. That's what I'm gonna do. I'll just rock it out.
So I feel bad about myself because I had the same shoes.
Nah, yeah, I had the same shit.
I'm wearing them in brown.
Can you run that song?
Ready?
Alright, hang on. First, I want to hear about the shoes.
You heard about the shoes.
We got the shoes, man. We're trying to get
the music. So you playing Leroy, right? You made the beat.
Oh, yeah, play Leroy. Because listen. C4 made the beat for Leroy. He's about to play Leroy.
Alright.
We're going to kick it over Leroy.
All right, and then I guess put a flyer up, if you don't mind.
It's breathing.
So, name it again.
The name of the song is Leroy. It's more of like an interlude on the track, but it's got a lot of replay quality to it. So.
And the guy who made the beat has the Morgan Freeman freckles.
C4. That's
C4. Okay. All right, go ahead.
He was old when he was sick.
God, y'all. You know the little man on me, cause I got the glowing like I'm Leroy Stunning boy, I be stunting. I'm a C4 underscore 99-100, and I'm fresh dressed, going excess. See me coming with a bad one. Yeah, I get the glowing like I'm Leroy Stunning boy, I be stunting. I'm a C4 Stunning boy 99-100, and I'm fresh dressed, going excess. See me coming with a bad one, and you know it's mighty fine and nothing. I'm a flip boy Stunning boy, I be stunting. I'm a C4 underscore 99-100, fresh dressed, going excess. See me coming with a bad one, and you know it's mighty fine. Don't be the one to bring the drama to, for the feed is nominal. I'm thinking presidential rally, what would Obama do? I give a fuck about no police, I'm totally binary. That's peace and love and whatever this whole name held it down to do. I told you I'm an entertainer, and I make these kind of moves to count them new blue hundreds and lay up by the pool. I'm about to do and make it dirty. You heard we got the flu, and even though I'm unsturdy, I finally got my groove. Now how about you? I found out, like I'm that dude that's hot out, but I got that food if it's sell. Put it on the scale, you knock out. Put the clock on snooze and I'm out. No, I won't lose. Feet up, put the drop on cruise and I swerve. I got the word from this bird. Tell me I'm the truth. I'm yelling, what's up? I'm yelling, what's up? You hating on me as a fuck up. I'm waiting, rush up. I'm making 40s on a Friday to wait a lush up. I know it's retro, but the petrol got me waving, what's up? About to take off a nigga like me. Make you wanna buy the tape off a nigga like me. She about to fuck the brakes off a nigga like me. Cause she know that I'm on and that I always keep it 99-100. About to take off a nigga like me. Make you wanna buy the tape off a nigga like me. She about to fuck the brakes off a nigga like me. Cause she know that I'm on and that I always keep it 99-100. 100.
That was awesome. That was pretty dope. Got my mic back? I don't care if they can see me. I don't need to be seen.
See,
as long as they can hear this soothing baritone.
Oh, that could be good.
I'm an aspiring voice actor.
Are we on it?
An aspiring voiceover actor.
Are we playing another song or what are we doing?
I think we're just doing one song. Yeah. Oh, we're almost out of time. Oh, yeah, we're out of time.
Wait. So play another one real quick.
No. I gotta close. Okay, I got this sponsor. Yeah, come back to me.
Okay, true that.
Come back to me.
Nah.
You're not back to me. Hey, we're back to me. Yo, shout out to you guys, man. DJ Bone is with us now.
You. What's up?
These cookies are just like melting on my fingers. All right, 3 minutes. I gotta give it back to the sponsors. Shout out Schwartz Auto Body, 200 Blydenburg Road, Nylandia. If you have a fender bender, you got a ding, you got a little scratch, something. Girlfriends, ex-girlfriends, whatever. Sometimes they like carve their name in your car with their keys, or you probably your knife that they stole out of your pocket, mm-hmm. whatever. So just 200 Blydenburg Road in Islandia. Go see my girlfriends George and George Jr. Schwertle. Schwertle. It's every consonant in the alphabet.
Schwertle. I'm about cool to jack that. Thing.
What's Schwertle. Coming? What do you guys got coming up?
What do we got coming up?
More than likely...
We got 47 seconds.
All right, Club Love. Also, you can go get these cool-ass hats.
How do they get in touch with you?
You can... Really, mostly, I'm at Instagram, on Instagram, at Good Morning.
Where's the underscore? There's an underscore, right?
There's an underscore after Good Morning, and then 45.
All right.
He's High Art Bone.
High Art Bone!
Find him on SoundCloud, everything, man.
Find me on SoundCloud. iTunes, Spotify, Amazon.
Tidal.
Awesome.
Tidal.
Xbox,
motherfucking Pandora.
Devin, you were absolutely hilarious this evening. Thank you for doing your thing, man.
Thanks, Devin.
Fucking really funny. Tell the people how to get a hold of you.
You can find me on Twitter or Facebook. Facebook, Devin Giannini, or Devin, lowercase... For Devin, then capital G, then comic.
Look at Kenny's face.
At Twitter.
At Twitter. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Mr. Lee West. This is my best friend, my brother, my love, Brian Cadet.
Peace.
We're leaving.
Doo 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 doo.
Boom boom!
Yeah!
427!
Oh, shit. Man, what a shit. We're still on.
Yeah,
okay,
we're
all
right. Oh, yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
No, it's free spray.
Good cookies, man. I can't even, like, say anything. I'm like,
Salute.
Peace.
Salute.
My bad.
Is anybody eating that half of it?
I thought everyone knew that it was special cookies.